Once upon a time, in an enchanted forest, two dukes were hunting for an elk. While searching for one of the arrows that had strayed away, they stumbled upon a peculiar rock formation. As they were getting closer, they felt an ominous presence around them. In between the rocks, they found an old chest. After some careful consideration, they decided to take the chest to the wise wizard, as nobody knew the forest secrets better than him. When they reached the wizard's lair and knocked on the door, it opened up with a boom, and they could see that he had been expecting them. "Come, come quickly. It's too dangerous for the chest to stay out in the open." Inside, the wizard instructed them to hide the chest and keep it sealed, as there is an evil spirit inside, powerful enough to corrupt the purest of hearts. Later, one of the dukes had risen to the rank of king and ruled over a big area. It had been long since the chest had crossed his mind. However, his daughter Katharina had fallen under the spirit's temptation and one day went down to the cellar and opened the chest. Smoke came pouring out and she was overcome by terror. It was as if she was inside a bad dream. At the same time, the king was giving a speech in front of his loyal subjects. But then suddenly, he was possessed by the evil spirit. King Vlad's appearance changed. He then put all of his subjects under a terrible spell that bound them to his will. Katharina witnessed all of this, and frightened, she ran to Duke Oleg's castle. She tried to explain herself to him, but they ended up arguing. Duke Oleg was scared. They were discussing what to do And finally, they decided to ask the wizard for help. Wizard were alone. The wizard handed him a magical blade and told him, "The path to defeating the evil shall be hard, for the blade will only work if it first takes the prince's life." Duke Oleg was struck by despair, but he knew that for the greater good, he had to vanquish the evil king. He sent a messenger to all of the other dukes in the kingdom, telling them about the situation and calling them to arms. Most of the dukes answered his call, and so Duke Oleg had raised a great army. On the morning of the day of the battle, Duke Oleg met Katharina. He said that he loved her, but before she could answer, with a heavy heart, he pierced her with the blade. As she drew her last breath, the battle was fierce, and many were slain, but Duke Oleg managed to get to the king. They engaged in a mighty sword fight, their swords clashing. However, when he saw an opening, the Duke took out the magic blade and he stabbed the possessed king. A terrible shockwave ran through the kingdom. The evil had perished. Duke Oleg walked through the battlefield, shocked by the sight of all the people that had perished. It was a grim day. However, this feat had once again brought peace and hope to humanity.